was a study to learn what we don't know. What will happen to Washington school buildings when we're hit by a moderate or major earthquake? Here's what we learned.
The average building is expected to be 43% damaged in a design level earthquake, and a majority of the buildings are expected to be red tagged, so they're unsafe to occupy.
Out of more than 220 buildings tested by the DNR, hazard geologist Karina Forsen said many Washington schools, especially those built before 1975, are vulnerable to earthquakes.
Those older facilities are more at risk.
The project involved $1.2 million from the state. The DNR hired a team of engineers who used tools to test the buildings.
Well, we were looking for the type of material the building is, how well connected it was, when it was constructed.
David Swanson was one of those engineers.
The goal of the study isn't to single out bad buildings or a bad district. It's really to highlight the fact that there are these needs that really are throughout our state.
A problem, Forsen said, will cost several billion dollars to fix. Upgrades to buildings can cost anywhere from $63,000 to more than $5 million.
One of the interesting and great things I think that we found is that the cost to seismically upgrade the building is much, much less, 5 to 50% less than the cost to actually create or build a new building if the earthquake were to damage it.
But many school districts are already struggling financially, which is why they want this state-funded study to inspire a statewide solution.
Some of our most valuable assets are in these buildings, and they act as a gathering place in an emergency and a disaster. And so it's vital that these staples of our community are up to seismic code and that they are able to withstand the earthquake shaking.
Callie Greenberg, King 5 News.